Simplified Options Uganda, together with Professional CV Writers Incorporated, present 5 Lines That Are Killing Your CV by Ivan Ngono, read by Eddie Chigozi. Are you struggling to set your CV apart? With a number of jobs seemingly requiring similar skill sets, CVs can often end up looking like virtual replicas of one another, making the hiring process more difficult and more irritating for recruiters. And much of it simply comes down to an over-reliance on the same old stock phrases. To help you ditch the clichés, here are 5 lines you should stay away from when you are writing your CV. Number 1. Although I don't have much experience in... Hiring managers are not immediately attracted to candidates that constantly apologize. Not only does it show a lack of confidence in your ability to do the job at hand, it also emphasizes your shortcomings instead of focusing on what skills you actually do have. If it is a skill or qualification that is essential for the job you are applying for, apologizing is not going to persuade the employer to consider you. And if it is not 100% necessary, why mention it? Either way, you are unlikely to ever come out in a positive light after your admission. In fact, if you doubt yourself, the employer will probably doubt you too. Remember, think about what you can offer in a role instead of what you cannot offer. What you should do: focus on what skills and experience you have that make you a good fit, and draw attention to those instead. Be positive, confident, and sure of your abilities, and recruiters will be too. Number 2. I am great at multitasking. Let us face it, multitasking is important for almost every role. Unfortunately, this has led to a phrase which has been so overused in CVs that it has probably lost all meaning to employers. We are not saying that the ability to multitask is not a valuable attribute. However, simply including that you are good at it provides very little value to recruiters. You actually need to back it up. Think of relevant examples of when you have put your multitasking skills to the test and how they have been employed to benefit the business. It is all about how you say it, not just what you say. What you should do: talk about any tasks you have done that exemplify your multitasking skills and use them to quantify your claims. That is to say, how you managed multiple tasks to achieve a successful outcome, and what the outcome actually was. This way, you are avoiding the cliched phrase that almost everyone has in their CV and replacing it with a tangible example that makes your CV unique. Number 3. I am a team player who also works well alone. Chances are you will be good in a group and working individually. Most people are. However, the real problem with this phrase is not the fact that it is notoriously overused. It is that it doesn't really say a lot. To an employer, saying you are a team player who also works well alone just looks like a slightly lazy way of trying to cover all your bases, because you feel that maybe one of them might be a necessary requirement. Essentially, it is the CV equivalent of sitting on the fence. So instead of including both, why not focus on the one that the role requires the most? If you are going to be working in a team, then focus on that. If it involves working independently, utilize those skills instead. Simple. What you should do: to avoid recruiters skimming over this point, make it mean more. Demonstrate a time where you have proved your success of working in a team, or how you have completed tasks independently. It will sound much better than the generic wording and will also represent your skills more accurately. Number 4. I am a perfectionist. Whether you use this phrase on its own or couple it with its even more irritating prefix, my biggest weakness is, this point simply has no place in your CV. Even if you genuinely are a perfectionist, this over-exaggerated character-defining phrase often translates as, I am really picky over minor details. In reality, nothing is perfect, especially in the workplace. If an employer reads about your obsession with perfection in your CV, they may be left wondering how you would really react when things don't go according to plan. Either that, or you are trying to pretend that you really have no weaknesses, other than your pursuit of greatness, which unfortunately is something recruiters can spot a mile away. There are not a lot of positive outcomes. What you should do? Be honest. If you give recruiters enough of your skills, achievements, and experience, they will be able to make an informed decision on what you are really like, and never ever bring up weaknesses in your CV. Save that for the interview. And number 5, I am a people person. Although this attribute is incredibly important to have for a number of jobs, particularly customer-facing ones, it is a bad idea to include it in your CV. As with most cliched phrases, it doesn't have much meaning. Doesn't everyone have the ability to speak to other humans, at least to some extent? Additionally, it is likely that your CV will be sent to someone in HR, and members of this industry notoriously dislike this phrase. So not only will you be using an overused line, you will also risk mildly irritating the person with the power to move your application further. Without any context or elaboration, this is essentially just a fancy use of alliteration, and one that your CV could definitely do without. What you should do? Don't be afraid to demonstrate your people skills, but display them in a way that effectively describes your communication skills, customer service experience, and affability all at the same time. Proven instances and examples of successful interactions and good relationships with colleagues or customers will always work in your favor. Ivan Nkono is a human resource consultant and professional CV writer. If you have any HR or CV related issue that you need help with, contact Ivan on WhatsApp. The number is +256 772 481 995.